The President's counsel will respond first to the question from Senator Hawley and the other senators. When he took office, Viktor Shokin, Ukraine's prosecutor general, vowed to investigate Burisma. Before Vice President Joe Biden pressed Ukrainian officials on corruption, including pushing for the removal of Shokin, did the White House counsel's office or the office of the Vice President legal counsel issue ethics advice approving Mr. Biden's involvement in matters involving corruption in Ukraine or Shokin, despite the presence of Hunter Biden on the board of Burisma, a company widely considered to be corrupt? Did Vice President Biden ever ask Hunter Biden to step down from the board of Burisma?
Mr. Chief Justice, Senators, thank you for the question. We're not aware of any evidence that then Vice President Biden sought any ethics opinion. We are aware that both Amos Hochstein and Deputy Assistant Secretary of State Kent testified, Amos Hochstein is in the public domain, Deputy Assistant Secretary Kent testified in the proceedings before the House that they each raised the issue with Vice President Biden of the potential appearance of a conflict of interest with his son, Hunter, being on the board of Burisma. Deputy Assistant Secretary Kent testified that although he raised that issue with the Vice President's office, the response was that the Vice President's office, the Vice President was busy dealing then with the illness of his other son, and there was no action taken. So from what we know, there wasn't any effort to seek an ethics opinion. We're not aware of an ethics opinion having been issued. Although the issue was flagged for the Vice President's office, we're not aware that President Biden asked his son to step down or that any other action was taken. And I believe that Vice President Biden has said that he never discussed his son's overseas business dealings with him. Thank you.
So,
Mr. Chief Justice and Senator, I appreciate your question. The facts about Vice President Biden's conduct are clear and do not change. Let's go through them. First, every witness asked about this topic testified that Mr. Shokin was widely considered to be a corrupt and ineffective prosecutor who did not prosecute corruption. Shokin was so corrupt that the entire free world, the United States, the European Union, the International Monetary Fund, pressed for his office to be cleaned up. So I would caution you to be skeptical of anything that Mr. Shokin claims. Second, witnesses, including our own anti-corruption advocate, Ambassador Yovanovitch, remember that very dedicated anti-corruption ambassador, testified that Shokin's removal made it more likely that investigations of corrupt Ukrainian companies would move forward. Let me repeat that. The dismissal of Shokin made it more likely that Burisma would be investigated. Third, Burisma was not under scrutiny at the time Joe Biden called for Shokin's ouster. According to the National Anti-Corruption Bureau of Ukraine, an organization several witnesses testified is effective at fighting corruption. Shokin's office investigated Burisma, but the probe focused on a period before Hunter Biden joined the company. But again, in another investigation was warranted, dismissing Shokin would have made that more likely.
Thank you.